Alejandro Garnacho, the 18-year old who has been on the lips of every United fan all over the world and the entire football fraternity, not until Ronaldo came in through and really threw in that interview that made a very huge diversion of Alejandro Garnacho. But I know this boy will go on and really do the same thing again and again on the return of the Premier League in December. Welcome to United Matters channel. How are you guys and where are you watching us from? Rock and David is my name. Smash the like button, comment and share. And if at all you're watching us for the very first time, lower right bottom corner, we are left with just 60 subscribers to hit 9,000 subscribers onto this channel. Guys, endeavor to subscribe to this channel so as not to miss out on stories that we do upload in here on a daily. But I'm sorry that yesterday, I think these other 2 days, my internet really had a very huge problem and my internet company couldn't come here in time to restore my internet. But today morning, they came home and they really restored it, and obviously we are going to be having a very huge marathon as far as this United channel is concerned. So let's get into the story. You remember that three players were nominated for the player of the month of Manchester United of November. So, and it's now official that Alejandro Garnacho has won Manchester United's player of the month award for November. Alejandro Garnacho really had a very good month of November. He played very well and obviously convinced the manager Erik ten Hag, and very many people really have been talking about him to an extent that even when a player of Argentina got an injury, people thought that maybe they would opt to go on and be bringing a player who goes by the names of Alejandro Garnacho to go and play in the World Cup. Now, the website of United, where I hate to say that, 18-year-old attacker Alejandro Garnacho has been voted Manchester United's player of the month of November following the standout 11 days. With the season taking a break for the World Cup in Qatar, the Reds played a total of just 4 games in November, but Alejandro Garnacho more than made his mark. Across our matches, the youngster scored 2 goals and assisted twice as the Reds ended the first part of the season on a positive note, courtesy of his last-minute winner at Fulham. Then they continue to let us know that the Argentinian started the month in the best positive way, scoring the winner in a 1-1 away triumph at Real Sociedad, his first senior goal for the Reds. Garnacho raced in behind the San Sebastian side's defense and finished a devastating counter-attack in style, giving United supporters a flavor of what was to come from him in the next fixtures. Alejandro Garnacho started his first Premier League game on the November 6th away to Aston Villa. While the Reds were disappointingly defeated by 3-1, the 18-year-old made sure his side avoided a repeat of that when the villain visited Old Trafford in the Carabao Cup 4 days later. That is Alejandro Garnacho. Then they went ahead to let us know that starting on the bench, the youngster joined action just after 1 hour mark and United trailing 2-1 after Marcus Rashford leveled the score on 67 minutes. The Argentinian winger stole the headlines. First superb passing saw the Reds with the ball high up the pitch before Alejandro Garnacho set up Bruno Fernandes to Erik ten Hag's side in front. And then in added time, the 18-year-old cut inside effortlessly and produced a simply sublime pass to Scott McTominay, which the midfielder finished. Following his performance against Villa, fans were clamoring for Ten Hag to start Garnacho away to Fulham in United's last game before the Premier League. At Craven Cottage, you know all what happened that side. Alejandro Garnacho went ahead to score what we call the winner, because that game was tied at 1-1 and it needed the effort of Alejandro Garnacho to come in through and convert that Ericsson's assist into the back of the net to make it 2-1 for Manchester United. But who did Alejandro Garnacho go ahead and beat to see to it that he becomes United's player for the month of November. Let me show you how the fans of United voted and what percentage did this young man earn from the fans of United. Now, Alejandro Garnacho was competing with Casemiro, David De Gea, and himself. Then Casemiro got 12%, David De Gea got 21%, and Alejandro Garnacho got 67%. It shows you how much he took the headlines. But I believe the player that most of the people are not really giving an eye are Casemiro. But I'm so much happy that he is into the contention that fans have given him 12%. I believe ever since he started the first Premier League game of United against Everton, he has been a revelation. He has changed lots of things at Manchester United and given us the best drive from the midfield, a position that we've been calling for its reinforcement at the club of United for over 3-4 years. They finally addressed it. And you see the difference. And you see the difference. Because I believe if Ole Gunnar Solskjaer had signed a central defensive midfielder at United, lots of things would have changed. He wouldn't have even gotten a sack, because I believe even if he was playing with Harry Maguire in that central defense, when you are having a person who is going to shield it and knows what to do, especially in a CDM like Casemiro, things would always go his side. But for Alejandro Garnacho, he deserves to win it with 67%. The fans have spoken. And you know, the fan speaking is really something that the club really wants. And that's why it's the fans that are really voting, because these numbers are the ones that have made United what they are. Having been a club that has not been winning ever since Alex Ferguson left, we are trying to go on and really show the needful. But Alejandro Garnacho has beaten De Gea and Casemiro to win the November Player of the Month award of Manchester United. And I believe he's really going to get more and more and more better. I'm so happy that he never won for the World Cup. You saw my reaction, and Ten Hag was asking himself whether it was going to be the right decision for him to be taken to the World Cup. Reason being, he believes he needs a rest right now. After getting that rest, well-deserved rest, he just needs to go on and return to play the two fixtures that United are going to play before the World Cup returns in Spain. Then he prepares for Burnley on the 21st of December. And I believe he's going to be one of those players that are really going to impress into that game of football. Because I believe Burnley is really a team we should beat. We should beat to see to it that we go to the quarterfinals of the Carabao Cup. Remember, Man City is going to cancel itself with Liverpool. Not so? Meaning that if at all we proceed and win the game of Burnley and we go through to the quarterfinals, we'll be left with either Liverpool or Man City, meaning that Ten Hag will just need to go on and beat that one team to go on and win the Carabao Cup. I believe even if Newcastle is here, if Ten Hag's squad is really available and really doing what he wants to do, these players can win him the first trophy of Manchester United. I told you my reason as to why I want us United to win the UEFA Europa League or the Carabao Cup in Ten Hag's first season, because I've seen Mourinho brag that the hardest job he has ever had is managing Manchester United. Reason being, he won the UEFA Europa League. That is the biggest trophy United has so far won. So let's wait and see what's going to happen for Alejandro Garnacho as far as the next phase is concerned, starting from the 21st of December to the end of the season. And I know Ten Hag is really good at managing young players, and I believe Garnacho is in the good hands of a manager that has been here, and he's really good at doing the part of the job he's doing at United. So let's wait and see what is going to happen. So your reactions to Garnacho winning Player of the Month of November are welcome in the comment section below. Smash the like button, comment and share. Rokan David is my name. First video of the day. More stories are yet to come. Bruno Fernandes has replied to or responded to Ronaldo's interview that we let out in the media. And very many others. Ryan Rooney. I've seen Antony. I've seen Rafael Varane. and very many others reacting to this. So I believe it's going to be a next story, if at all there is no story that really develops. I'm out for now. See you later. But Bruno Fernandes yesterday scored a brace for Portugal in a game that Ronaldo missed out because he had problems in his stomach.